the actual Christmas day, but we are celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ. We are here together as a body in unity, just praising and worshiping the Lord. And I want to thank everyone for being here today. And I just appreciate all the smiles on your faces. That lets me know that you want to be here, that you want to get something from this day. Every time we come in these doors, we are seeking something. So today, if you don't have that something, someone here, Pastor Terry or Phil, they're going to tell you how, and even I will, how to receive that something. We're going to stand, and we're going to sing with all our hearts this first hymn. And then Terry's going to come up with some announcements and all. I'll introduce y'all to him in just a little while. He's been out for a little while. If you're able to stand and just sing with all your heart to Jesus Christ. Oh, come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye, oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Sing, choirs of angels, sing in exultation. Oh, sing, all ye citizens of heaven above. Glory to God all, glory in the highest. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Thank you, Frederick. Good morning, everyone. Whew, it's good to be back. I know you've heard it before, but I'll tell you this morning, it's good to be anywhere. Praise God for what he does for us when we need him, right? Amen. Well, listen, I want to tell you Merry Christmas first and emphasize the word Christ. Amen. I don't care what anybody tells you. The world celebrates Christmas, and there's one reason we celebrate it. It's because Jesus Christ was born, and we're here to celebrate his birth today. Just got a couple of announcements I want to make for you. We're glad you're here to worship with us. This is a good crowd. Wasn't that breakfast good? Yeah. Woo! Thank you for all who worked back there and all who brought the food. That was really so good. I want to let you know we'll be having Bible study this Wednesday night, 7 o'clock, okay, for those who can come. There will not be Awanas this week. That will start back the following Wednesday, okay, the next Wednesday. So keep that in mind. Sunday, we're going to have a regular Sunday day, okay? We'll have a Sunday school at 9:45 and then the service at 10:45, and then we'll eat lunch. Does that sound good? So keep that in mind for next Sunday. I know it's New Year's Eve, but what a great way to bring in the new year, right? Now, this morning, we want to start off with something just a little different this morning. I know this is the time when we recognize Christ's birth. But to tell you very honestly, you can't really celebrate Christ's birth without celebrating his death. You know why, don't you? Because he was born to die. He came here to die for my sins and for yours, and that's what Frederick was alluding to a minute ago. And once you become to believe on Jesus Christ and you believe in his death and resurrection and what he did for you, you can be saved and have eternal life. I hadn't got any better news for you than that this morning. Praise God. So what we're going to do this morning is we're going to celebrate communion. And as we celebrate his birth, we're going to remember his death, because that is so important. And he commands us to do that, doesn't he? So we're going to ask some of the men from the church to come and get the sacraments here, and they're going to pass them out to you. If you will, just hold on to those till everybody gets it, and then we'll all partake together. Okay, I'll read a scripture, and we'll partake together this morning. Okay? Let's see. Wendell, could you come and help them with that? Paul, maybe? Yeah, that'd be good.
Thank you.
Has everyone been served now? Okay. In 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter, we're told a man ought to examine himself, and that includes ladies too, ought to examine himself before he eats of the bread and drinks of the cup. For anyone who eats and drinks without recognizing the body of the Lord eats and drinks judgment on himself. So if there's anything in your heart this morning that you need to commit to God, if there's any sin in your life this morning, let me tell you something. God will forgive you. And he will forgive you right now, but you need to pray that prayer of forgiveness and repent this morning, okay? And then let's all together remember that he gave his body for us and he shed his blood for us so that your sin could be forgiven. Praise God. That's the only way. There is no other way. So we're going to take just a moment for you to pray silently. And if there's anything in your heart that needs fixing this morning, Jesus Christ can and will fix it. Let's pray. God, we do thank you for your forgiveness this morning. We thank you that you are a loving God. We thank you most of all for your forgiveness. And God, we just pray for forgiveness for everyone here this morning who has spoken and asked for it. And God, we know you're faithful and you will do it in Jesus' name. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this, and whenever you drink it, do it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Lord Jesus, we thank you again for what you have done for us. Now we pray that blood will be applied to all of us. God, if there's any sin in our life this morning, we know your blood can and will cover that. We pray that we would seek that forgiveness, Lord, and that we would look to you. We thank you, God, for being born on this earth and living among us as one of us, for going through the same heartaches and trials that we go through. And God, you came out victorious. Even when you were being put to death, even when you were being beaten, you were being victorious. And you were defeating sin for every one of us. And when you came out of that grave, praise God, you came alive again. And because you came alive again, we'll come alive one day. And we thank you so much for that. There's no better promise that you can give us. And we just praise you and love you this morning in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, at this time, I believe, before we take the offering, we've got the kids are going to come and sing. I think it's very appropriate after taking communion that we sing "Happy Birthday, Jesus" this morning, don't you? And so they're going to come now.
day, Jesus. I'm so glad it's Christmas. All the tinsel and lights and the presents are nice, but the real gift is you. All the carols and bells make the holiday swell, and it's all about you. Happy birthday, Jesus. Jesus, I love you. Happy birthday, Jesus. I'm so glad it's Christmas. All the tinsel and lights and the presents are nice, but the real gift is you. Happy birthday, the holiday swell, and it's all about you. Happy birthday, Jesus. Jesus, I
love you, Jesus.
Well, amen. Now that was worth coming and eating breakfast to hear, wasn't it? Praise the Lord. We're going to ask you to stand at this time, if you would. This is going to be a time of giving our tithes and offerings to the Lord. Blessing bowl is in the middle aisle. Now listen to me for just a second now. Stay at your seats. When you bring your offering, go back to your seat. Okay? We're not going to be doing all the fellowshipping this morning. We got something special still to go, and I know you want to hear it. But while we're taking the offering, we'll ask those singing in the cantata to come on up and be prepared. And so as soon as we take the offering, we'll have the cantata this morning, all right? Y'all ready for that? All right, well, let's stand and come bring your offerings to the Lord this morning. Some of you just can't help yourselves, can you? All right, we're going to ask you to be seated now. We're going to have a word of prayer, and then I'm going to turn it over to Keith, and they'll close out the service this morning. And I do want to thank Keith. Amen. Y'all thank him. Amen. And we want to thank all these folks up here behind me who have practiced so hard and prepared for this. It's always good, isn't it? And we're looking forward to it this morning. So thank y'all for all of the hard work and for preparing and getting ready this morning. Somebody calling me? Yes, sir. January the 5th, do you believe, here at 7 o'clock? Okay, all right. Thank you, sir. Father God, we do love you this morning. We've said that several times, and God, we can't say it enough. And thank you so much for your love for us. for caring for us. God, for the ultimate sacrifice that you made. Lord, may we remember that during this time. Lord, and I know in the morning, Lord, some folks are going to be thinking about Santa Claus and presents. But as I tell our kids and tell folks all the time, Santa Claus may be good one day during the year, but Jesus Christ is good every day of the year. Amen. May we remember that, and may that be in our thoughts during this Christmas season. Bless the cantata now. Thank you for Keith and those who have worked so hard. God, may their music penetrate our hearts this morning. May your spirit be in control of what happens here today. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Before we get started, I do have a couple of announcements. This week, I asked for everybody to bring me all their gifts from the angel tree. Rod said that there was 34 kids that he had names for and 61 seniors. Out of those 34 kids, our church sponsored 13 of them for the seniors, and then I had 17 kids' names that were given to me from within the church, from within the community. So together as a church, we were able to help 34 families this year. It was an absolute blessing. I'm going to try to get through this part. But Wednesday night, I took all the gifts to Rod. And Thursday morning, I went and I helped. I was able to help them, you know, whenever they came and pick up the gifts. Rod told me, he said, Krissa, I was not even going to do an angel tree this year. He said, I did it last year by myself, and I was so, he said, it was just a lot. He said, but the same day I told myself that I wasn't going to do it, you called me. And you wanted names for an angel tree. He said, so you're the reason why we did this angel tree for the community. That was a huge blessing because seeing the people come in with just tears streaming down their face was just awesome. And I'm so glad that we were a part of it. Our church was a part of it. It brought so much joy to me. So Christmas cards, can y'all please just make sure you get all your Christmas cards out of the back today? It's getting kind of full. And then there's a blood drive, Gordon United Methodist Church, the 26th. If you want any of that information, please see me and I can get it to you.
Amen.
I got Sophie's. Check, check. Is she on? She's on. Check. Is it? Okay. Me and her about the same height, so that works well for her. We were last week, but she's changes so fast. I just wanted to mention about the cantata. We picked, really, these are songs from old cantatas going back to 2008, I think, when some of them were written. It's still very contemporary. It's about Jesus. And really, we pull from three different ones. So Kyler and Brian and different ones have been working really hard to try to even get it where we can present it without having hiccups and things. We got a bunch of DVDs and split track CDs, and we're showing one thing over here and something different up here. And so hopefully all that kind of just goes right over your, you know, you don't know about it. And if I hadn't said anything, you wouldn't know about it either. But it's going to be good, really, because our focus is to glorify Jesus, glorify the Lord. And this really, the theme of this is about he came. Jesus came. You know, he didn't have to come. He didn't have to do things the way he did, but that's the way he chose to do it. And the scripture says in Hebrews that this is his final word. He's not coming back to try to coax us anymore or, you know, try to come up with a different idea of how he can have fellowship with us. He's already expressed himself through his son, through the birth as a man, and through an ugly death on a cross. And can you imagine that people don't accept that? They want to define a different way to know God. I want you to know today there is no other way. Christ has poured himself out. It says in John chapter 3, this verse you all know, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. So the first time he came, he didn't come bringing judgment, condemnation. He really expressed himself in grace and truth for people to know God, have that final opportunity, you might say, to know who he is. And John 1, it says, he was in the world. And though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. And just think of God offering this and people still rejecting and turning away from the living God. It says, to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. So I want you to think about those things as you read the words and you listen to the presentation, that God, he came for you. And if you haven't received him, if you hadn't believed on him, then really think about that now, as Terry's already mentioned, in different ones, that this is an opportunity to accept Christ into your heart. I brought this because I knew I'd forget about it. Gary was pushing reading through the Bible, you know, a few months back. And I had already started reading through, and I finished in August one time through. And I said, all right, but I read straight through. I said, I'm going to use Gary's book here. I'm going to start again and see if I can get it done by the end of, read it twice this year. And so I've been following the plan in the book that you put together, you and Carissa. And I just want to tell you guys, if you haven't read, if you want to start this year, we have plenty of these. And it's really a good way to read through the Bible. When you're reading in the Gospels, it kind of puts the same stories together. So you're seeing how that one story is repeated over and over. So it's not straight through written. It's written in a way that you're reading things that are kind of, like some of the prophets, you might read some in Isaiah, then you'll jump over to Jeremiah. And so I like the way it's arranged. It's been really good, and it's really helped my understanding of God this second time through. So please think about that at the end of the service. If you want to read through the Bible, if you want the material where it'll help you, you can check it off as you go. Then see me. We've got plenty of these made up.
Come! Because of your tender mercy, the morning light from heaven is about to shine, is about to shine. Because of your tender mercy, though we have walked in darkness, you will end our night. You will end our night. Let the heavens rejoice, let the angels sing, let earth receive the King of Kings, so holy, so worthy, you come to us. Because of your tender mercy, to every generation, you have shown your love. You have shown your love. Tender mercy, you are forever faithful, reaching down to us, reaching down to us. Let the heavens rejoice, let the angels sing, let earth receive the tender mercy. Let the heavens rejoice, let the angels sing, let earth receive the King of Kings. So holy, so worthy, you come to of your tender mercy. Because of your tender mercy.
it never happened? What if Jesus never came? What if the manger in Bethlehem had never held a newborn king? And if angels had never announced his birth? What if God had never reached down into our darkness to send a Savior? Oh Lord, we're so thankful that you couldn't leave us without hope.
Before you came, we were stranded in the dark, bearing wounded hearts without hope. Before you came, we were drifting on the sea, desperate and in need, sinking low. We cried for help, 'cause we could not save ourselves. You heard, you saw.
Restored, you fed us with your word, bread of life.
When we were crushed underneath the weight of living, you heard, you saw. In your presence, I am humbled by your love, and I am overwhelmed, and I am overcome. I am breathless in your presence, I am humbled by your love. You have.
You can.
I'm breathless.
sing joy, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Now our salvation is come. Sing joy, sing out the wonders of his love now. Let every heart and every voice, oh, sing joy.
Sing joy, sing joy, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Now our salvation has come.
Yes, he has.
Sing joy, sing out the wonders of his love now. Let every heart and every voice, oh, sing joy.
Joy to the world, joy to the world, joy to the world. He's come to save us. He comes to break the captive's chains.
Born is the King, born is the King, born is the King, the Prince of Heaven. Now and forever he will reign. Sing joy, sing joy, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Now our salvation has come.
Yeah. Joy to the earth, joy to the earth. The curse is broken. He's come to make his blessings flow. Oh,
let every heart, let every heart, let every heart prepare him room here. Come, let us make his glory known.
Oh, sing joy,
sing joy, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Now our salvation.
Yes, he has.
Sing joy, sing out the wonders of his love now. Let every heart and every voice, oh, sing joy.
Joy to the world, joy to the world, joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let everybody sing joy.
Come on.
Joy.
Shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night.
An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people.
Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord.
This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests."
You are the first, you go before. see the starry host declares your glory.
Glory in the highest. Glory in the highest. Glory in the highest. Apart from you, there is no God. Light up the
your guys' day.
There you go.
Mm-hmm. A little silence is nice.
Amen.
To a point.
Plan revealed through the law and the prophets to
to fulfill the redemption of men. He spoke after centuries of silence in the midst of a still starry night. And Emmanuel came down among us, and the Father said, let there be light, let there be light, let it shine bright, piercing the darkness with dazzling light. Hope for the hopeless was born on that night, when God sent His Son and said, let there be light.
People walk in great darkness, heaven from near and far. Shepherds with flocks in their keeping, three kings who followed a star. Together the poor and the riches, witness at Bethlehem night.
And the sky full of angels announcing the birth of the glorious light. Let there be light, let it shine bright, piercing the darkness with dazzling white. Hope for the hopeless was born on that night, when God sent His Son and said, let there be light. We who are His have this calling to praise Him and make His name known. So one day the presence of Jesus shines in every heart and every home. Let there be light, let it shine bright, piercing the darkness with dazzling light. Hope for the hopeless was born on that night, when God sent His Son and said, let there be light. Piercing the darkness with dazzling light. Hope for the hopeless was born on that night, when God sent His Son and said, let there be light. Let there be light.
All right. Let there be light. Gives a new thought to the first words in Scripture when God said, let there be light. I believe He had Jesus in mind from the very beginning. And He is the light of the world. And we have an opportunity to serve and worship Him. God is so good.
Amen.
We thank Him so much for all that we have here and all that He's provided. We pray this year coming up would be a year where we really make Him known in this community. And it's many, many ways to do that. But that's our goal this next year, to make Him known throughout this community, in this state, and even this world. Thank y'all so much.